He is still hooked to a side cable, the SP, that's what's holding the vehicle now. When he rotates his bed and puts it in position, he'll hook with his deck winch. Then he'll release the side puller and winch it right up on the deck. And as you can see, the tow truck itself is on an incline too. That's why all the stiff legs are down on this side with blacks under them, kind of leveled up. So this will work on a pitch. It will work on a flat surface as well. And this is where you separate the boys from the men. Now I'm going to try to get a little closer here so you can actually see what's going on. You can see his side puller's still on there. He just pulled his deck winch out. And if you look under the truck, there's the guardrail. We have plenty of room underneath there. It clears it with ease. Now we'll watch him pull the truck up on the car. Removing his SP cable. And now I'm going to try to get another angle here. Just to give you an idea of what the angle is we're pulling up on, this bed will tilt a lot further than a normal flatbed. It's designed to go over guardrails, designed for deep pitches. You gotta remember, we're on a downhill grade too, so that means the cameraman's on a downhill grade, but it's a pretty good drop off. We are over the guardrail. And now what he's gonna do is secure it. And we just secure the car so it don't bounce around as much. putting the strap right on it. Once we get this sucked in and rotated, we will then put their 4 points of hook onto it and secure it down. Okay. Now he's going to rotate the truck. I'll try to hold it still as best I can for you. And that is how you get over a guardrail without touching it. And again, this is on quite a pitch. And we're approximately a foot, foot and a half away from the guardrail. And that was all your clearance there. Never touched the guardrail once. The actual time in this video was 15 minutes and 36 seconds.